Welcome to Marina Heights Field on the campus of the University of Oklahoma. Sooner softball is on the air and underway. Giselle Juarez throws the first pitch that's in for a strike to Northwestern's leadoff hitter, Skylar Schellmeyer. And welcome in. It's softball time in Oklahoma, along with Destiny Martinez. I'm Chris Plank. Thank you so much for joining us here on a gorgeous Friday night for softball as the 0-1 pitch is up and away for ball one. Sooners looking to extend their 37-game home winning streak, Destiny, and that's pretty impressive.
Yeah. No, I mean, winning games on this home field is so important to our fans, and just getting them so invested into the whole season, kicking it off every home game is so important to them.
Northwestern coming off win number 15 on the season. They just walked off Drake in extra innings here in the second game of the Sooner tournament as the 2-1 pitch is right on the inside corner for a strike. Northwestern with Schellmeyer, their center fielder, squaring off against the lefty G. Juarez, who has been on another level since the Sooner trip out to the Mary Nutter Classic. She took two no-hitters into the late innings in those games, I should say, as the count is now full at 3-2. She carried a no-no against BYU into the fifth inning. Carried a no-hitter, 6 1/3 against Arizona. Full count, sit out. One away, first strikeout of the game. Giselle Juarez throws it right by her. There's a good look at the junior transfer from Arizona State. 6-0 now on the season is Juarez.
That's a huge out. Way to set the tone, first inning out.
Here comes Rachel Lewis, the second baseman. First pitch to Lewis is in for a strike. Well, strikeouts, nothing new to the junior transfer. As a matter of fact, the K to start the game. And strikeout number 51 already on the season in 37 2/3. This is up high, 1-1. Here's Rachel Lewis. Sophomore. Liberty Township, Ohio. This is in play. Nicole Mendez will make the play in right center field in front of Jocelyn Allo, and there is quickly two away. So that's a sneak peek of the Sooner outfield. Here's what the infield looks like for the Sooner. Sid Romero over at third, the birthday girl. She started every game so far with the Sooners, as have Grace Lyons, a short, Kaylee Clifton at second, Shay Knight at first, and Lindsey Elam behind the play. There's G, 6-0 on the season, as the first pitch is right on the outside corner to Maeve Nelson, a shortstop, for strike one. What might be even more impressive about that ERA of 2.06 is how good she has been since February 22nd. That's trouble. It falls in front of a view. First hit, first base runner of the game, a two-out single for Maeve Nelson. You know how good Arizona is and how good their offense is. She went out there and struck out 11 of them and allowed just two hits in 7 innings.
That's impressive. I mean, I'm just sitting here kind of watching how her ball is moving and her speed and the way that she's mixing up every pitch. She has really good command and control over her pitches.
Nikki Cochran, the designated player, left-handed hitter, steps in. Cochran on the season, a 375 hitter. Don't think you'll see much movement from Nelson over at first. She hasn't attempted a stolen base yet this season as the 1-0 pitch misses low ball two. We are just underway on a Friday night in Norman, Oklahoma, and Northwestern. One of four scheduled for the Sooners this weekend as the 2-0 is thrown right by. Swing and a miss, strike one. We kind of set the Sooner infield slightly for you. The outfield has a view in left, Mendez in center, and Allo in right. Jocelyn just off your screen. There she is. 2-1. Swing and a miss, 2-2. Two.
One thing I really noticed that's kind of interesting to me is the grades of the Northwestern team. There's a lot of underclassmen starting this lineup.
They are very young. Yeah. That's a good point for Kay Drohan in her 18th year. 2-2. Out of play. Young team for a veteran coaching staff. Drohan and her twin sister, Carol, have done a fantastic job replacing a legend in Sharon Drysdale. Retired Hall of Famer. Of course, we are familiar with their pitching coach, and we'll talk a lot tonight about Michelle Gasflin. 2-2. Boy, that ball. You see Juarez kind of keeping herself cool after nearly getting the K there. It looked as if Cochran just got a piece of that as it popped out of the glove of Eva. 2-2 count. Juarez brings it home. Good job staying alive by Cochran as she fouls that one of them. Well, Destiny, I know you patrolled all outfield positions, but I don't know if I've ever seen a center fielder playing as shallow as Nicole Mendez is right now.
No, I don't think I've ever seen that either.
She is, as you can see, right between the interlocking O and U in center field.
She's quick. She'll get there.
2-2 up and away. Popped out of the glove again of Eva. I can't stop watching Mendez now. After a couple of pitches, she'll walk towards the bottom of the U on the O and U. She moves back a little bit now. Good job by Theron Smith, our producer, to give you a shot of that. Full count. Sit down. Swing and a miss. Strike three. G. Juarez threw it right by her. Sooners give up a hit, but that's it. We head to the bottom of the first inning. Oklahoma and Northwestern are scoreless. Here's tonight's starting lineups presented by Love's Travel Stops. And there's CeCe, Kaylee Clifton. What a leadoff hitter she's been, Destiny, because she just finds a way to get on base. All-time leader in hit-by-pitches in Sooner softball history.
Right. I mean, whether she's getting hit by a pitch, dropping a bunt, hitting a double, I mean, she can really play all parts of the field. She's got it. She can do so many things in the starting role to really set the tone and get the game rolling.
Love's Travel Stops, clean places, friendly faces, and it'll be quite a challenge for the Sooners tonight against this well-coached pitching staff of Northwestern as Kenna Wilkie will get the start. And the righty misses up high for ball one. Wilkie, just a sophomore, Destiny. You talked about that in the top half of the first inning. You look at this starting lineup for the Wildcats. And it's freshman, sophomore, freshman, freshman, freshman. Oh, there's a junior and a couple of seniors and then two sophomores in the middle.
Right, yeah, they're young. But that's awesome. I mean, they're going to have room to grow. A lot of potential for this team.
Kenna Wilkie, as you see, 4-1 on the season. This is her 10th appearance, 7th start. CeCe pops this one into shallow right field. Could be trouble. Newport makes the catch in foul territory. One away. That's been a bit of a struggle recently for CeCe. She was 0-for-3 in the Tuesday win over McNeese. And here comes one of the most dangerous hitters in college softball, tying a single season record with 30 home runs last year for a freshman, National Freshman of the Year, Jocelyn Olive.
She is just so talented. I mean, I've seen her hit balls on all sides of the plate, up, down. I mean, it's just tough for these pitchers to throw to her.
First pitch is in for a strike. Hasn't been the power surge yet this season. She had the 2-home run game against Hofstra out in the St. Pete Clearwater Invitational. 0-1, grounded back up the middle. Nice play to knock it down by Wilkie, 2 away. 2 outs for Sid, the birthday girl. Well, she didn't quite get all of it, but a good job by Wilkie to stay in front of it. That can be a scary play for a pitcher. Especially whenever we've seen Jocelyn Allo hit a couple of pitchers with hard balls.
Right.
And you're already a little bit maybe shaky, but a good job by Wilkie there.
Yeah, I mean, if you see a ball coming off the bat from Allo, regardless of how hard it's really coming, you're going to get a little bit nervous.
Boy, Sid has been on a tear recently. And she takes the off speed for a strike. She went 2-for-3 against McNeese on Tuesday night. It was her 79th career multiple hit game. 1 is up. Since the start of the Mary Nutter Classic, Cid Romero is hitting 521 with 8 RBIs and 3 home runs. She's the team leader on the season with 6 home runs. Pops that one foul and out of play. What impresses you the most about Cid Romero?
Her ability to make contact on, in any direction. When she's getting an inside pitch, I like to see her take that to left field. Outside pitches, she goes oppo. I really like that she's a disciplined hitter, and she can work all parts of the field.
Fouls that one back. 1-2. Good crowd. The Sooner Ticket Office, Sooner Athletic Department, announced earlier this week every single game this season has now been officially sold out. How cool is that?
Yeah, that's awesome.
Including this weekend's games. Obviously. The 1-2. Up and away. I don't think you would announce every game was sold out and then, oh wait, but we got a couple for this game, right? I don't think that would make a lot of sense.
Right. The fans are dedicated. It's awesome.
2-2 pitch here to Cid. You will not see that very often. Cid Romero called out on strikes. We'll head to the second inning. Solid first inning from Kendall Wilkie. Oklahoma and Northwestern are scoreless. A little bit of extra stage dry out there, a little bit more dirt, and we're good to go. As we head to the second inning of a scoreless game between Oklahoma and Northwestern, Jordan Rudd, the catcher. Right-hander will lead it off, a freshman, no surprise an underclassman as the first pitch is in for a strike. Juarez gave up the one hit in the first inning, a two-out single to Maeve Nelson, and that was it. There's the 0-1. Pie. We're going to check with the first base umpire who says no luck. Over at first base, that's Michael Parker, David Irwin at third. And Janet Tidwell is our home plate umpire tonight. On one, caught the outside corner. This is really your first chance extensively to watch G throw, isn't it?
Right, yeah, I haven't gotten to see her pitch at all. Pretty impressed. I mean, she's got a lot of command over her pitches.
Looking for strikeout number 3. Just misses. Good attempt at a frame job on that outside corner by Lindsay Elam.
Jordan Rudd's another freshman.
They're everywhere. Destiny, they're everywhere in this lineup. It's crazy. 2-2 pitch from G. Up in the zone, but not enough of it for Rudd to do too much damage as a view gets under the fly ball and makes the catch, and there is one away. Here comes Morgan Newport, the right fielder. Made a play in foul territory. To retire, Kaylee Clifton lead the game off. Fall A of you, senior. Big smile on her face is, this is one of only a handful of games left for the Sooners this season. Including tonight, the Sooners only have 8 dates left here at Marina Hines Field. The first pitch is fouled off for strike 1. There's a really good note that Andy Bean had dug up. Sports Information Director for softball. 38 of their 53 games on the road, 15 home games. It's the third fewest in the Patty Gasso era. Shea Knighton makes a nice play on the ground ball to first, and there's 2 away. In fact, 15 home games this year, ties for the third lowest in the country among major conference teams this season. Only Oregon State, who played here, by the way, and Iowa have fewer. Each of those teams are scheduled to play 12 home games in 2019.
What is the estimated full schedule?
53.
Right around 50?
Yeah.
Okay.
There's a good look at Kate Drohan in her 18th year as the head coach. And a lot of those teams on the list that play a lot of road games are usually cold weather teams.
Right, yeah,
it's a lot of big team, 10
yeah.
teams. Northwestern has been road warriors so far.
Yeah, you won't see Florida and UCLA traveling too much.
Here's the 1-0. Nice change of speeds, but missed up high. Only 54 miles an hour on the gun there from G. Two outs here. Morgan Nelson, the left fielder, digs in. Shows that bunt. She'll pull it back and take the 2-0 for a strike. It's kind of crazy, but if you're a diehard, you get it, or if you've played, how quickly the schedule just flies by during the softball season.
Yes, it's so quick.
Oh, my goodness. Here's the 2-1. Could be trouble to left field, but a view has a beat on it. Under it makes the catch just short of the warning track. And that's a quick inning for G. Juarez. Three up, three down. We head to the bottom of the second inning. Sooner softball presented by OG&E. Powered the speed of life. We're scoreless. Played since 1978. Destiny Martinez was not even born
the last time that happened. Wow.
And the first pitch to Shea Knighton is up high. But they called it a strike. Yeah, there's a... It's interesting because the Sooners haven't lost in ages. 15 of the last 16 meetings between OU and Northwestern have taken place in neutral sites, with the series opening in Norman in 1978. But that...
We forgot to tell them that it's Hispanic Heritage Night.
We did not do a good job of that. There's Knighton loops one to the left field, but right there to make the plays, Nelson. There's one away. There is a lot of pride, too. Los Sooners has been the t-shirts that were handed out. Of course, Cid Romero and Leah Flores playing on the Mexican national team. There's a good look at the left fielder, Nelson, for Northwestern, who made the play. Here's our player to watch tonight, Grace Green, who digs in. Boy, what a Tuesday night she had, as the first pitch is in for a strike. Scoreless here in the bottom of the second inning. Grace Green had been 0 for her last 11 before going 3-for-3 on Tuesday night against McNeese. Looking to stay hot here, but falls behind. No balls and two strikes. And when you get in a slump like that, especially as a freshman, Destiny, can be hard to get out of it, but she maintained.
Right. It becomes a mental game. I mean, you know that your ability is there. You know that you're talented enough. It becomes a game, a mental game, and that's what's tough to break.
She fouled that one off to the right. We had a chance to talk to her post-game on the radio network, and she's got a great personality. She is going to be fun to watch over the next, rest of the 4 years here. Shallow center field, going to be easy for Shellmeyer, who actually ended up having to take a few steps back to make the catch, and there's two away. There's no wind. I don't know if she just misread that, or maybe what little wind there was played tricks on her, but almost looked as if that was going to be an easy play in shallow center field, and she ended up, let's just follow her path. Charges
in. Misread.
She just misread it. That's all that was.
First step's got to be back.
Cardinal sin, right? For
Cardinal sin. You have to take that first step back.
Here's Fale Palema of View. First pitch is up high. Fale ended a six-game hitting streak by going 0-for-3 in Tuesday's game. But she got the Sooners' offense jump-started last Friday night here at home against Louisiana Lafayette. The 1-0 pitch misses outside 2-0. She sent a shot over the wall, two-run bomb, her second home run of the season that staked the Sooners to a 2-0 lead, and they never looked back en route to a 9-1 run rule win. 2-0 pitches in for a strike, 2-1. So now they need her to go with two outs in what's been a rugged offensive start for both teams. Only one hit between both OU and Northwestern. Pretty good pitch on the 2-1, but Fale does a good job laying off 3-1.
And you've seen this on both sides, the mix of the off speeds. Both pitchers have done a really good job of keeping the batters off balance.
3-1 count here. Shallow right field popped up. In fact, I think the second baseman, Lewis, is going to have the play. She does, and that ends the second for the Sooners. Watching Sooner softball presented by OG&E. Powered the speed of life. For scoreless, headed to the third. First pitch to Wilkie is outside for a ball. Kenna Wilkie leading off the third inning. A rarity, Destiny, anymore. A pitcher that hits.
Right.
We don't see that very
often. Both of their pitchers hit.
That's right.
That's one thing that Michelle really touched on when I talked to her about their team is both of their pitchers are strong hitters.
She loops this one to Grace Lyons, who gets in on the action with making the catch. How about this for a stat? Grace Lyons, at short for the Sooners, is making her 19th start of the season. There's only two Sooners that have started every single game for the Sooners this year. It's the freshman Grace Lyons and Sid Romero. Sid Romero. One away for Lily Novak. First pitch catches the outside corner from G. Juarez. Now, Kaylee Clifton could have been in that mix, but she came down with what was either a stomach bug or food poisoning or something at the Mary Nutter Classic as the 0-1 pitch is up high. So CeCe actually missed the Arizona game. And by our numbers, that was the first start Kaylee Clifton had missed since 3 weeks into her freshman season.
Wow.
Consistency personified from
she
the Sooner captain.
She must have really been sick.
The 1-1 pitch catches the outside corner, 1-2. Oh, she was. G. Juarez doing a good job of pounding the zone here. 1-2, just outside.
It's always fun to come back and see who's got the captain patch. I figured it'd be a toss-up between her and Sid. There's so many leaders on this field, though. It's a tough one.
The 2-2. Foul straight back. Coach Gasso said in the Meet the Sooners event that it's as close of a voting as she ever had for the captaincy.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Imagine when you have six seniors, and we were talking about it, Destiny, six seniors. No
They're
one is left.
Still here, right.
No one is left
right.
from the class. Everyone that was here on day one is still here.
That's tough. I mean, fantastic for the program, but it's pretty rare for a whole class to stick around all 4 years.
There she is, Patty Gasso. Just to her right, that's Jen Rocha. And a pretty good lefty behind her in Kalani Ricketts. A whole new look on the pitching side of this staff for Coach Gasso. 3-2 pitch is fouled back. Jen Rocha was giving us all lessons in how to properly speak Spanish if we were going to break it out of the broadcast.
She was trying. She was trying.
There is one thing I can say from the limited amount of time we've had around Coach Rocha so far through the first handful of games. She's really having fun being back in Norman. That could be trouble for Mendez. Nicole is actually going to have Olive cut in front of her and make the catch, and there's two away.
Kind of a toss-up there.
Jocelyn had it all the way. My first track is always on the center fielder, Destiny. Maybe I should start expanding that view a little bit to right field. Jocelyn, by the way, has really improved defensively as an outfielder this year. She made a throw a couple of weeks ago. That was as good as you've seen.
Seemed like she's picked up some speed, maybe taking better angles to the ball.
First pitch, the leadoff hitter, Skylar Schellmeyer, is up. Ball one. Schellmeyer led the game off for Northwestern with a strikeout. That's one of two strikeouts so far for G. Juarez, who has been fantastic through 2 2/3. Like that, 1-1.
It's a little different look for me this year, too, without the shift. No shift
Having,
on Paige Lowry.
That's a good point. We had 2 years of the shift with Paige Lowry. Everything is pretty much straight up. 1-1, but a foul. And again, you can't help but notice in center field, that was 66 miles an hour from G. Juarez. You can't help but notice how shallow Nicole Mendez is playing in center field.
This one's a little bit more understandable.
Right.
You got to slap her up.
Yeah.
But last time, the number four, three
hitter? Yeah, the three-hole hitter.
Yeah, maybe not so much.
In fact, as Destiny pointed out with a slap at the plate, a view is in a couple of steps in front of the patch where the normal positioning for a left fielder is kind of worn out a little bit, that green grass. It was a good look at Mindy's positioning. The 1-2. Swing and a miss. Juarez climbed the ladder and struck her out. Inning over. Wow. Sooner softball presented by OG&E. Power at the speed of life. We're scoreless headed to the bottom of the third inning. Nicole Mendez will lead things off for the Sooners as we head to the bottom of the third inning. Oklahoma and Northwestern are scoreless. Sooner softball on Sooner Sports TV presented by Budweiser. This Bud's for you. Enjoy responsibly. Proud partner of Oklahoma Athletics along with Destiny Martinez. I'm Chris Plank. Time is called by the home plate umpire. Darren Smith, our producer. Joel Manning, our on-site engineer. The most important position.
Joel.
And here's the first pitch to Mendez. That's up a little bit. Ball one. Boy, Mindy has been on a nice little run recently for the Sooners. The junior out of Houston has started the last five games and is hitting .363 during that stretch. One of those numbers might not jaw drop. Five RBIs in both of her home runs. That's two home runs after hitting zero last year. It's my nod to Los Sooners tonight.
Mendez has always been one of my favorites to watch, just because she's so, like, able to do so many different things.
Bunt,
clap, home run. She can play outfield. She can pitch. I mean, she's so versatile.
It reminds me a lot of Nicole Pinley in a lot of ways.
And Shelby, too. Shelby was very versatile, too.
Maybe a nod to Shelby because she pitches as well, too.
Right,
Shelby could pitch. Here's the 1-1. That's in for a strike. Though, as the great Jerry Pinley once told me, just about everybody can pitch, right? Because at some point, they had all pitched in their career.
Right, at some point, you try it. But then at some point, you realize you probably shouldn't do that.
Yeah, Wilkie has been fantastic so far tonight. Six up, six down so far for the youngster. And Mendez is probably going to be retired here as this is popped up in foul territory. The catch is made by Novak, the first baseman, and there's one away. Speaking of the first baseman, there is a new look inside the first base coach's box for the Sooners tonight. Kalani Ricketts is back over in the first base coach's box. I think you might guess the reason. I think she wants to be a little bit closer to Michelle Gasjoy.
Yeah, she wants to be a little
there
bit more involved.
Kalani had been the first base coach through a handful of games to start the season, and then Kelsey Arnold took over. But she requested to be there tonight, and how can you say no to Kalani?
You can't do that. Not when Michelle's in the dugout right next to her.
As the first pitch to the Sooner catcher, Lindsay Elam is lowing in for a ball, the Chickasha product. Lindsay had a hot start to the season, had a couple hits in their win over Syracuse, has struggled a bit at the plate. But I'll tell you what, she is a grinder. Remember Monday Night Football used to have grooms grinders? She is a grinder, man. She is working hard. She's in a battle right now with the job that Kelso has done. Pushing for playing time behind the plate. 1-1. This is up and away. Can you take us through the importance of having someone in that dugout to help you when you're a first-time starter? Elam, a first-time starter behind the plate for the Sooners, and having Leah Wodak to help her out as an assistant this year?
Yeah, no, that's important. I mean, especially just because you want to understand coach as best as possible, and it's kind of a tough thing to do on your own. I know that having GAs when I was playing, being able to talk to them and kind of pick their brains on what her expectations really are and how fast you need to meet them. I think just having somebody in your position and understand, and especially without Coach Lombardi, making that adjustment to a new coach as well, just having somebody to fill that role for you is important.
Great change of speed by Wilkie for the swing and a miss. Second strikeout of the game, two away. She pulled the string on this, didn't she?
Off speed.
51 miles an hour. Two away. Well, the Sooners need a little two-out magic here, and why not Grace Lyons? First pitch to the Arizona product is hammer. Deep to center field. Go ball. It's up, and it's gone. Home run, Grace Lyons. She did it again. A no-doubter over the batter's eye in center field, and the Sooners jump on top 1-0. That ball carried 262 feet.
And what I love so much about it is it was the first pitch. Just take advantage of it up in the zone, send it right back out.
Look at the concentration from the freshman, and boom. Does it get over the batter's eye?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Absolutely. So that is the 11th hit on the season for Grace Lyons, her 11th RBI, and her 12th run scored. That's what you call maximizing your opportunities. The Sooners jump on top 1-0 on the fourth home run of the season from Grace Lyons. Not a bad first hit. Here's CeCe. They're chanting for Lyons to give him a curtain call. I don't think Grace has made her way out of the dugout yet. Here she comes. 1-0. Pop foul. Is it going to get out of play? Yes. Well, actually, it just hit kind of off the netting awkwardly, and there was no chance for Novak to make the play. Kaylee Clifton flied out to right her first time up. See that C on the jersey, the captain. I'll tell you one thing that Wilkie does well is that 1-1 pitch misses high ball two. Very deceptive. When it's coming out of her hand, you don't know if it's going to be that nasty off speed or that 60-plus heater she can throw.
Right. She's able to really hide the pitches. I think that's what's tough. She's throwing rise balls, getting the balls back up in the air, and then mixing in the off speed, keeping the batters off balance. So it's tough to hit a rise ball pitcher that can also throw an off speed.
2-1 pitch was fouled back, 2-2. Heck of a play by the fans in the stands. Good crowd here tonight. Two balls, two strikes. The pitch. A fastball fouled away. 64 miles an hour. 64.6 to be exact. Kind of humming it up there a little bit whenever you're able to pull the string on a 50 mile an hour.
Yeah, that's tough.
Boy, Dunlap.
Oh, go ahead.
I was going to say, Dunlap's hugging the line on this pitch, too. She knew it was coming.
You don't want to get behind in the count against this pitcher.
Ball just off the glove of Novak in foul territory. I think the third baseman, Dunlap's tipping a little bit of what might be coming. You'll see her take a few steps towards the line. Though she's playing it pretty tight right now with CeCe. Here's the 2-2 pitch to the Sooner second baseman. Hammered foul.
It's really mixing in and out pretty well, too.
Kind of taking on the personality of their pitching coach, aren't they?
Michelle was tough. She was tough to hit. A lot of movement.
Two balls, two strikes. CeCe waits on a pitch outside that misses. Ball three. Now it's down to 53.
I know that's something that Michelle thrives on, too, is getting pitchers that could just move the ball. I know speed is great. You could get it by the hitters, but moving it around and it's slower, that makes it tough as a hitter to be patient in the box.
Well, CeCe's having herself an at-bat here. She wastes a good 3-2 pitch, fouling it back. We'll do it again. Six multi-hit games this year. Started the year 0 for her first six, and then went on a string where she was 9 for her next 13. Has been consistent ever since, and she walks with two outs. The home run by Lyons may have set the stage for the Sooners to add to their lead here. And here comes a legend walking back on Marita Hines Field, Michelle Gascoigne, for the first time since she was a player. What do you think she's telling her crew right here?
She's got to face Aloe. So I'm not really sure what Michelle could be saying right now.
Well, the one challenging thing with Jocelyn is you get this sense that the do factor is really high for a barrage of home runs at some
right.
point from Jocelyn. But with that said, I think you hit on it, Destiny. It's almost as if you've seen this growth as a complete hitter. Not as if
right.
she ever was it. She was just hitting bomb after bomb
right.
last year. But she's putting the ball everywhere
yeah,
this season.
Yeah, it's got to be tough to pitch to her. I think Michelle's advice would probably be to just keep the ball down and make sure that it's moving.
keep it away from one of the most dangerous weapons in the Sooner lineup, if not the most dangerous. Alo grounded one back to Wilkie her last time up. Takes the first pitch inside for a ball. Well, that Sooner dugout is alive now. One ball, no strikes. Alo had a cut, fouled it straight back. She takes absolutely nothing for granted, is what I dig about Jocelyn. Just because she hit 30 bombs last year, in her mind, it's not as if it's just naturally going to happen. She works hard. The 1-1. Just a bit up.
Right. She's very humble as well.
Very much so. I think we're starting to see more, too, of her personality start to come out. She's funny. She's outgoing. And she can mash. She fouls that one back and evens the count at 2-2. Sid Romero in the background waits on deck, wanting an opportunity here to add to this 1-0 Sooner lead in the bottom of the third. A two-out home run from Grace Lyons.
I think Alice should almost expect this ball to be out of her hands.
She hammered it foul. Jocelyn digs in with that open stance, left foot almost out of the batter's box. The 2-2 just misses, 3-2. Now you got to be real careful.
Yeah. Yeah, and then you got to face Sid.
Even if Sid gets on, you got to face Knight. There's no outs in this lineup. 3-2. Oh, swing and a miss on a nasty off-speed from Wilkie. And the side is retired, but the Sooners jump on the board thanks to a home run from the freshman Grace Lyons, a no-doubter to center field. Oklahoma leads it 1-0. Sooner softball presented by OG&E. Power the speed of life. First pitch misses outside to start the top of the fourth inning as Rachel Lewis, the second baseman, leads off. Sooners on top 1-0 on a bomb by Grace Lyons. Only the 2, 3, and 4 hitters here for Northwestern in the fourth. G. Warris has been fantastic. Allowed the first inning single, and that's it. Oh, she pulled the string there. Did she go? You bet. 1-1. Last time up, Lewis popped one into center field with a second out of the first inning. She bats here with nobody on the leadoff. And then obviously nobody would be on a leadoff in inning as the 1-1 pitch misses low and away to him.
A lot of pop-ups and strikeouts this game. A lot of pop-ups.
Not a lot of ground balls.
Yeah, I know.
Great point. There's the 2-1. 2-2.
Is layoff the rise or crush a change?
And oh, did Grace Lyons crush that. Here's the 2-2. Just misses. This run that G. Juarez has been on has been something else since the start of the Mary Nutter Classic. And there's a story behind it, too. 3-2. Barely staying alive. Coach Gasso told us on the radio pregame show prior to the BYU game on February 22nd, told her just to go back to what's comfortable. Kind of forget everything they've tried to change. To say it's worked out would be a massive understatement. 3-2 pitch. And there's a rarity, a walk. In that stretch, since February 22nd, the BYU game, that's just the third walk for G. Juarez, and Jin Rocha cannot believe it. There's a good look at the head coach of the Sooners, Patty Gasso. So basically, just go back to the basics. Go back to what you're comfortable with for G. Juarez, and it's worked. Including tonight now, 22 and a third innings, 9 hits, just 2 earned runs. And oh, the ball's thrown behind the runner. Good job backing it up by Alo. The runner slipped. They're going to throw her out at second base. Got her! Good job by Jocelyn Alo backing up the play as Elam tried to throw behind the runner. It got by Knighton into right field, and Alo throws an absolute strike. Look at this.
What a great job by Alo being there. I mean, you could see it was kind of a late jump, a little bit of a bobble, but she came up throwing.
Good tag, too. Good job by the freshman Lions and everyone understanding their responsibilities.
Right, such a strong arm, and the way that she turned after she barehanded that, I like to pay attention to the way that they pick the ball up in the outfield. If it's flat, if it's not moving, don't pick it up with your glove. So, and she did just that.
So one away with Maeve Nelson. So the walk is eliminated, and Jen Roach wants to have a talk. So let me finish this thought now. Through tonight now, 22 and a third inning, just 9 hits, 2 earned runs. With the strikeout, she's had 3 now tonight, 41 Ks.
In three,
over the last 22 innings.
Wow, and 3 walks?
And 3 walks now.
It's impressive.
I'm telling you what. And all it took, this is interesting here. Jen Roach said, I'll just talk to her. And the infield went back and chatted with each other. Now, a quick word with the infield. But
just by going back to the basics with the conversation.
Go back to the basics. Take everything that we've kind of talked about and just go back to what makes you comfortable. And I think the number was, what, 3 to 4 miles an hour she added on her fastball? 6 miles an hour that she added on her fastball. Credit to Kyle Cantu, video coordinator and jack of all trades for Sooner softball, as the 1-1 pitch is in for a strike, 1-2 to Nelson.
I mean, when you take it back to the basics and you begin to have fun again, and I think that that's a big part of it, mentality. Obviously, being a D1 athlete is pretty tough, but if you make it harder on yourself by changing everything, and it takes the fun out of it. So getting back to the basics and just making the game fun again,
1-2
you're
going
to perform a lot better.
This is up. It's 2-2 here. With the one out, top of the fourth. The Sooners, thanks to the Grace Lyon shot to center field, lead it 1-0. Fouled straight back. There's also the factor that you throw in with Juarez is that she didn't get here until January. And when she transferred from Arizona State, her first day on campus was the start of the second semester, so.
Yeah, so she had a lot of adjusting to do.
A lot. 2-2.
And not only on field, I mean, that's academically, that's housing, it's a whole lifestyle change.
Wait, that's strike 3. I don't know why. Let's watch this again. That's strike 3. The home plate umpire has the strike call wrong. That's strike 3. You see, Elam chases it down. They throw to first. The scoreboard had it at 2-2 before that pitch. We had it up here at 2-2. The live stats had it at 2-2. That's strike 3. I think Kate Drohan's going over. Boy, we're all confused right now. So that's a good look at Janet Tidwell. She's the home plate umpire having a conversation with Kate Drohan. The batter, Maeve Nelson, is still standing there. Somebody has the count wrong.
That must be strike 3.
Yeah, that should be strike 3. And you can see Drohan is protesting. Yeah, they had a strike call, and a foul ball. Now they're giving a warning to Drohan. I've never really understood. Yeah, that's strike 3.
That's an out.
Thank you. Finally. I mean, the umpire made a mistake. When they got together and they called a strike 3 looking, so put that backwards K in your scorebook. I mean, I understand if you want to get on the umpire and say, hey, you had your count wrong, how dare you?
But, right, but as a hitter, you should know that.
You should know. And there's two away, and here's Nicky Cochran. That is the least dramatic strikeout maybe of G. Juarez's career. And the first pitch to Nicky Cochran is low for a ball. Cochran, a strikeout victim. It's one of four, as we mentioned, which means since the BYU game now, is good job fielding her position by Juarez on the bouncer back. That's 42 strikeouts for G. Juarez over the last 24 innings. Unreal. Sooners lead it 1-0 as we head to the bottom of the fourth inning. Time for a Red Carpet Charters look at what's on tap in Sooner Athletics. We'll be back here tomorrow at 1-6 as Oklahoma takes on Drake in Grand Canyon. Drake pushed NorthWestern to extra innings here earlier today before NorthWestern knocked them off. That's a big one inside the McCaslin Fieldhouse as the men's gymnastics team takes on Illinois. And then, of course, softball wrapping things up against NorthWestern. Sid Skye's one foul. Red Carpet Charters, the official motor coach carrier of OU Athletics. As we head to the bottom of the fourth inning, along with Destiny Martinez, I'm Chris Blake. Darren Smith, our producer. Michael Cord, our director. And the 0-1 pitch. That ball's drilled to left field and gone. Oh, Sid Romero bombs one into the night, and Oklahoma has jumped on top 2-0. Sid, stay hot. 2-17 down the line, and she is fired up as she airplanes into home plate. It's 2-0 Sooners.
I mean, she just gets inside that ball. She sees it up in the zone and just takes it to left field.
Wow. And she knew it. We knew it. The fans in left field
right
knew it.
Bat.
A river wind hotel home run, and Sid's fired up. The birthday girl hitting a blast. Quite the birthday present for Sid. As the Sooners have opened up a 2-0 lead. That is for Sid Romero, her team-leading seventh home run of the season, and RBI number 19, which also leads the team.
Way to start an inning.
Can't beat that. There's the 0-1 to Shea. She leaves the yard. When will that land? Oh, my goodness. What a shot by Shea Knight. Above the left field. And the Sooners go back to back. Oh, baby, what a blast. It's 3-0 Sooners. Did that thing land yet?
I don't think so.
Watch this. Oh.
No.
254 feet.
Over the bleachers.
Another Riverwind home run. And for Shea Knighton on the season, how about adding to the home run total? Number four. They want a curtain call from Shea Knighton, and they just got it.
And it almost looked like the same pitch that Sid just hit out.
So the Sooners lead it 3-0 on three solo home runs. It did look like the same pitch.
I think it was the same exact pitch. She's leaving that up.
That one got stuck a little bit.
Up and at their hands.
So the Sooners as a team right now, this is game number 19 on the season. Michelle Gascoigne's going to make her way out to the circle. Have now hit 32 home runs as a team this season. Unbelievable. And a smile on the face of Patty Gasso as this sellout crowd at Marita Hines Field being led by the Sooners in a Boomer Sooner chant. I mean, my goodness. Three no doubters, too. Grace Lyons shot to center
way
field.
Out. I mean, they're clearing the stand.
Sid shot to left. And Shays shot that, I don't know, may have actually landed on Asp. Oh, my goodness. Here's the 1-0 to Grace Green, who hits one hard to center field and deep. But making the catch at the warning track is Shellmeyer, the center fielder, one away. Oh, It looked as if it might at the very least get over her head, but Grace Green gave it a ride. Schellmeyer took an angle to this one, didn't she, Destiny?
She did. First step definitely went back. But she's playing so close. She covered a lot of ground for that.
Here's Fale Palima of View. She popped out to second her last time up. Three zip Sooners. I don't know how you feel about this, Destiny, but it seems as if, and maybe it's just something I haven't noticed in her previous 3 years, almost as if Fale's gone a little bit more split grip than she kind of has in the past.
Yeah, no, I'd agree with you on that.
Good job staying tight to the batter's box as the 1-0 pitch misses inside, too.
That may have a focus on controlling the barrel longer through the zone, keeping that top hand in more control.
2-0 pitch. In for a strike. We have the best way to stay in contact with us during our radio broadcast is our Twitter feed at OU on the air. And we've loved hearing from you tonight. We'll share some of those as the broadcast goes on as the 2-1 pitch is ripped into right field. A base hit for Fale Palima. First hit for the Sooners that isn't a home run. But I like this from Nancy. She says, a guy just sat down in her section, said to everyone he told his wife he was going for a walk. He just didn't tell her he was walking to the OU softball game. Good man right there.
That's
well, he can't go anywhere because now the bats are on fire since he sat down.
Yeah, he better stay here.
Sooner's going to use a pinch runner here. The senior Reagan Rogers will pinch run for Fale. Throughout the season, whenever Reagan Rogers has checked into pinch run, she stayed in as a defensive replacement, so we'll see if maybe Reagan stays in left field for Fale, or maybe if they move her over to right. We'll keep an eye on that, but Reagan Rogers into pinch run here in the bottom of the fourth. Sooners on top 3-0 and Nicole Mendez. You mentioned the versatility of Nicole Mendez. Here is an area where Patty Gasso likes to use it. Notice the third baseman Dunlap in quite a bit at third.
Right.
That won't stop Nicole from laying one down.
Right. And Nicole, I mean, has a speed, and then putting Reagan on the bases, I'm sure something is going to... Yeah, I'm sure she's going to have something up her sleeve.
The first pitch misses to Mendez. Rogers as the pinch runner, which had been her role for her first couple of seasons. Now... she's started so far this season 12 games. She has 21 career stolen bases. There's a beautifully placed shot by Mendez right over the head of the third baseman. You couldn't walk out there and place the ball any better
than
that.
No, you couldn't. And as a slapper, I mean, I know Mendez is able to hit, bunt, clap, but as a slapper, that is your goal. Hit that 5-6 hole, make your defense work, and that's exactly what she did here.
I mean, you caught Nelson, the shortstop, going the wrong way. Dunlap was charging. Pretty good person to share your little stories with over there at first base and Kalani Ricketts. Kylie Lundberg will pinch in here. One of the six Sooner seniors, and I think that might be it for Wilkie. As Kate Drohan has emerged from the Wildcat dugout with lineup card in hand. I don't know if we'll see the freshman sensation Danielle Williams. I would imagine that they would save her for Sunday. Kind of surprised we didn't see her necessarily start this game. Well, they even going to make a change at all.
Keeping her in.
I'm going to stay with Wilkie. Infield is in. Runners at first and second. Here's Kylie Lundberg. We might see a change, but we don't. The first pitch to Kylie, swinging a miss, strike one. I mean, they made zero changes. I can't help but wonder what that was about. Usually when a coach has that kind of conversation, something changes. The 0-1 pitch misses low. 1-1 to Lundberg. I don't understand that throw back on Rogers either. She was not even off the back. Luggenberg, Lakewood, California product by way of Etiwanda High School, hitting 222 on the season, two for her first nine, and she pops one deep to right field. Get out of here, ball. Oh, baby, over the party patio. It's a home run for Kylie Luggenberg. The senior touches them all, and Oklahoma has blown this game open in the fifth. It's now 6-0 on the second, number two of her career for Luggenberg. Wow.
What a shot.
She almost outran Mendez at first base.
And every shot that's been hit today has been an inside pitch to each hitter.
Well, if there wasn't a pitching change after that, they might just go ahead and let the Sooners roll. My goodness. Third, fourth home run of the night. Riverwind brings you our home runs. And a game that was 1-0 heading to the bottom of the fourth is now 6-0 Sooners as there's the curtain call for Kylie Luggenberg. And here's Grace Lyons. All she did her last time up was send one out of here. And all right, now we have to have a change because this is the second time that we've seen Drohan. Pitching change brought to you by Air Comfort Solutions, your total home solution for plumbing, heating, and electric. Plumbing, heating, air conditioning, and electrical. Make the winning call today as the first pitch is in for a strike to Grace Lyons. And there's a good look at Morgan Newport. This is her sixth appearance of the season. A 1.79 ERA for the lefty, and Lyons launches one foul. Oh, my goodness. I think Grace Lyons is kind of feeling it tonight. Here's what she did earlier in the game. This was the first hit of the game for the Sooners for the Peoria product. Woo. Let's see if she can match it here. She's behind on the count, though, 0-2. Misses low, 1-2. Sooners lead at 6-0 as we head to the bottom of the fourth inning. Lyons on the season now has upped her batting average to .306. And two misses. Well, I believe the count's 2-2. I think the scoreboard is correct here. Let's see, the home plate umpire will correct it. Lyons, as we mentioned, had struggled just a bit heading into tonight's game, but she shook that off, and now she ropes one into left field for a base hit. Grace Lyons with a multiple hit game. Well, I'm not one to get too carried away in these kinds of numbers, but a blast here, and suddenly we're in uncharted territory, Destiny Martinez. Heading into tonight's game, by the way, Grace Lyons had just been two for her last 11 since the Grand Slam against Hofstra. And all she's done here tonight is hit a bomb over the center field wall and rope a single into left.
Seems like she's patient in the box, really getting a pitch that she can work with.
Very Kaylee Clifton-esque as CeCe takes the first pitch low and away for a ball. A five-run fifth has blown this, or fourth, excuse me, has blown this game open. 6-0 Sooners. As Jocelyn Allo waits on deck. Trying to protect the runner. She swings through a pitch on the outside corner. Doesn't matter. Lyons steals the bag.
Missed hit and run right there.
Yeah. I don't know what you can do with a pitch like that. Regardless, though, Lyons is now 3-for-3 on stolen bases this season. For the Sooners, that's the team leader. Oklahoma hasn't been big on stealing bases, but they've been incredibly efficient when they've done so. As the 1-1 pitch misses inside, 2-1. Allo waits on deck. There's still only one out here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Two balls and a strike to Clifton. Grounded back to the pitcher. Lyons is going to go ahead and take third as shovel to first to get the out. There's two away as Jocelyn Allo becomes the ninth batter to hit this inning. Pardon me, the A. Nope, night. Got a little bit carried away on my score sheet there. This is what happens when you use pen instead of pencil on your score sheet. You get in trouble. A good look at Newport, the lefty. Talking about all the youth on this roster, and here's Newport, one of the few upperclassmen that they actually use, a junior. Alo struck out her last time up, which is a rarity. She wants in on this home run party as the first pitch is up for a ball. Oh, you know she wants
in. I'm ready to see an Alo bomb. I haven't seen one this year. No, that's not true. I watched the game on TV when she hit two out.
Hofstra game. Here's the 1-0. Grounded softly towards short. Nelson up with it. Throws it away. Runner will score. Joss is on her way to second base. She'll miss the tag. No, they got her. Jocelyn got a little bit overly aggressive, but the Sooners have jumped in front thanks to the long ball. A commanding performance at the plate with home run after home run after home run. And Oklahoma has been a senior home run show here tonight, leading 7-0. G. Juarez back to work. She has been sensational here tonight. Through four innings, has allowed just one hit and has struck out four while walking just one. Sooners lead it 7-0 as we head to the top of the fifth inning. Northwestern will try to rally here with Jordan Rudd leading things off. First pitch is just outside. Along with Destiny Martinez, I'm Chris Plank. Aaron Smith, our producer. Michael Cord, our director. A cast of thousands helping make this broadcast possible. As the 1-0 pitch is bounced foul. Impressed with what you've seen so far, Destiny?
I am. I'm very impressed. The off speeds on both sides, though. The off speed pitches are getting me. OU has definitely caught back up. But both pitchers are dealing the off speeds.
I mentioned the G. Juarez switch that's flipped since the trip to Palm Springs. It's on display here tonight, the 1-1. Just a bit up. Two and one. That, unfortunately, this isn't a great example because she's falling behind, but she hasn't fallen behind a lot of hitters tonight.
Yeah, no, she's definitely painting the corners and making them chase and then getting a rise ball in there and off speed making them chase.
Grace Lyons ranges out. Ooh, look out. Grace tumbles over Reagan Rogers. As we speculated, when Reagan came in to pinch run for Jocelyn, Reagan did indeed come in and play left field. So, Fall A of you. Her night may be done, or maybe when the lineup turns back around to Fall A, she'll hit. Oh. Reagan did what she could to try to woe up there. Just
a little lack of communication,
Couldn't hit the brakes quick enough. One away for Morgan Newport. That's popped foul well out of play. Now, there's certain teams in sports when they get on a run, you realize you're in trouble. The OU football team with their offense, when Kyler Murray or Baker Mayfield the last few years get rolling, you know you're in trouble. Maybe Golden State in the NBA, they get on one of those runs and you realize you're in trouble. When this Sooner offense gets going like it did last
inning. Oh, it's scary. It's unstoppable.
Six run, bottom of the fifth inning.
And if Coach Gasso loves that, she encourages to pass the torch. Start the inning off, pass the torch. And I think with that momentum, the team is able to really accomplish that.
0-2. Oh, my goodness, G. Juarez, that's unfair. Two away. That, for Juarez, is strikeout number five. Ooh. So the Sooners led off the fourth with a home run from Romero, and then they passed the torch to Shane Knighton with a home run. And after a ball that nearly was an extra base hit from Green, back-to-back singles and another bomb. Two away, and the first pitch is in for a strike to Morgan Nelson. Flat out to left her last time up. Here's the 0-1. Oh, Juarez threw it right by her. 65 miles an hour. 0-2. Sooners looking to make quick work of Northwestern here in the top half of the fifth. Juarez misses high. Seven runs on seven hits. That's what you call efficient for the Sooners. Here's a 1-2. Swing and a miss. Strike three. Gee, Juarez, straight dealing. As we head to the bottom of the fifth, a run could end it for the Sooners. Oklahoma leads at 7-0. First pitch to Sid Romero is laced. Is it fair? Just foul down the left field line. Great job by our camera crew. Had a good look at that as Sid Romero, who homered her last time up. Look how close this comes, destiny.
I thought it was...
Just foul. Romero, 1-for-2 on the night. The birthday girl. About to end it on a walk-off here. The 0-1. Check swing foul. Tried. Sooners have been on an absolute tear over the last 2 weeks. Despite losing three games to weather. Make sure I say that very slow. They're losing. They lost them to weather. The 0-2 in the dirt. 6 in a row since their loss to UCLA. Love to see this team now get a chance to play UCLA and Florida State again. 1-2. Line shot right at the shortstop. Heck of a play by Nelson. One away. That's a hard hit ball, a hard out. And here's Shea. All she did her last time up was hit a home run. Eight run rule wins so far for the Sooners this season. They had a stretch the first 2 weeks where they had won in run rule fashion in four straight games. First pitch to Shea misses outside. We appreciate everyone checking in on Twitter. From Grace Ann down in Northport, Teresa Lakin, our buddy Jeff Jameson, Colin, Nancy, Miss Jane Jetson, Tiffany Myers up in Ridgedale, Missouri, Miss Wheelchair Mama. All the regulars checking in tonight with the Sooners on top 7-0.
Fans are incredible.
Reno,
you have regulars on Twitter?
Reno, Nevada. Granny Karen's checked in from St. Cloud. Cheryl Glass down in Butler, Alabama. Amber in Lander, Wyoming. The 2-0 pitch is in for a strike. Alexis in Louisiana. You name it, we've got it covered here. Sooner Sports TV and the Sooner Radio Network. Two balls and a strike to Shea Knighton. Shea on the night is 1-for-2. Hit that no-doubter last inning. Bounce this one. I stayed fair somehow. There's quickly two away. I mean, that ball had some kind of English off the bat. It looked like one of Theron Smith's wedge shots. Here's what's ahead for Sooner softball. We'll be back tomorrow. Kind of a unique look to the doubleheader. We'll play Drake. And we'll be on the air. We won't play Drake. Dessie or I won't. The Sooners will. At 1 o'clock tomorrow. And then we'll get a little break before the 6 o'clock showdown with Grand Canyon U, who lost earlier today to Tulsa, despite having handed Florida State its first loss of the season during the midweek. Grace Green hammers one foul. And then we'll be back here on Sunday for a rematch with the Wildcats. Green's 0-for-2. Behind on the count here, no balls and a strike. So, Reagan Rogers has moved into the on-deck circle, which may mean Fall A Abuse Night is done. Here's the 0-1 to Green. That's in for a strike, 0-2. Why not play Reagan Rogers? You've had home runs from seniors most of the night. Who knows? I mean, Kylie Lundberg comes off the bench and hits one. You had a home run from Sid Romero and Shea Knighton. Why not? Let's see if Grace Green will give her an opportunity here in the fifth. The 0-2. Now foul. Grace Green has never played first base before. And in fact, she had been playing third during the fall, but she hit the ball so well, they had to find a spot for her in the lineup. So they started working her at first in DP, and she credits Shea Knight to helping her out a lot. How amazing is that?
Yeah, no, that's awesome. To have an upperclassman willingly teach you her position, I mean, that's special.
Shows you, too, how important team success is and making sure that next wave
right.
is prepared as well. That Shea Knight, someone who's going to play her position some, she's helping her out. 1-2. Now's the foul. And if you were to ask Shea about it, it would be like, well, I mean, that's what I do.
Yeah.
I mean, hey, that's so impressive. Really?
And
what'd
I think that has a lot to do with the atmosphere that coach has created. Nothing's ever really set in stone. You don't ever feel like this is my position. You might play there most of the time, but she makes it very clear that if you don't perform at your very best, it can easily be taken from you.
Shot foul off the netting. Grace Green might not have a hit tonight, but she's had a couple of really good at-bats. After back-to-back shots by Romero and Knighton, she hit one that Schellmeyer made a pretty nice play on the warning track. She takes ball two.
I've noticed that Newport's not throwing anything up in the zone on the inside part of the plate. She's trying to keep it on the outside or down and in. Most of the home runs have been
up and in. You say ouch as Grace Green
yeah.
fouled that
right,
at right
the
over.
Hand. Ouch.
2 balls, 2 strikes. Grace Green gonna make sure the grip is good. As Newport brings home the 2-2. This miss of ball three. If Green can get on here, Reagan Rogers will get her first at bat, we assume, of the night. She's in the on deck circle and ready. 3-2. Might not get a chance this inning. Bounce to short. The throw is online and on time, and that ends the fifth. We head to the sixth inning. Oklahoma in control, leading Northwestern 7-0. Sooner softball on Sooner Sports TV, presented by OG&E Power at the speed of light. Giselle Juarez is done for now, but what a night. 5 innings, 6 strikeouts, and allowed just the 1 hit, which came back in the first inning. Unbelievable, just the 1 walk. And the lefty was feeling it tonight in front of one of the great lefties in Sooner softball history, and Kalani Ricketts over at first base coaching the Sooners in that Sooner dugout, and Michelle Gascoigne in the Northwestern dugout. Shannon Sale will check in. A good look at the FIU transfer who has really made her mark so far this season. You almost get the sense that there is the possibility that she could develop into almost a Paige Lowry type role with this team. Almost a closer's mindset. But she's been equally as impressive as a starter. Had one rough start. That was the game against Florida State. But she can bring the heat, and she transferred in, so she had the whole fall to spin the team, unlike Giselle, who came in January. So it's been a little bit easier, I think, for her to be able to acclimate herself. And I'm excited for you to see her, Destiny.
Yeah, I'm excited to see her as well.
Another good look at the junior. A majority of the Sooner pitchers are juniors that they use. There's the numbers on Shannon Sale, and you'll notice that the incredible ratio from strikeouts to walks, 45 strikeouts to just 5 walks. And a pinch hitter here is Danielle Williams will bat for
Not
Northwestern.
Not a lot of walks with the staff.
None.
Collectively, wow.
With the 1 today by G. Juarez as the first pitch misses outside for a ball. That is just 25 walks for the Sooners on the season, and now 116 innings.
Wow.
And what's crazy about that number is the 1-0 from Sale finds the strike zone. What's crazy about that number is the highest walk total is from Mariah Lopez, who has walked 11 so far this season, which at last check was more than she walked all of last year, as the 1-1 is off two balls and a strike. Like when Mariah threw her no-hitter this year against Florida Atlantic, she had walked three in that game. Swing and a miss, two balls and two strikes, which by checking our records was the most she had walked in a game since her freshman year.
Oh, my goodness.
Shannon Sale tonight now. Here's the 2-2. Ooh. Called strike three. Thought for a moment they weren't going to give it to her, but they did, and there's one away.
Danielle Williams.
Wow. Delayed call. There you go.
Shannon has a little bit of a different approach as well. With Juarez in there, she's kind of calm, collected. I feel like she has a little bit more energy out there on the mound, showing a little bit of excitement.
Lily Novak steps in. She takes the first pitch for a ball. That's what I've been so excited, not just on the TV side, for those of you that are able to follow along that aren't listening on the radio simulcast, as this bunt is foul, but also for the fans here at Marietta Hines Field to see a little bit of the attitude that Sale has. She has a certain it to her when she steps in the circle.
She does. A little bit of swag.
She wears the headband. She's got the routine. She confidently looks over at Jen Rocha to get the call. That stare in, and she brings it home. I mean, she is all attitude and has the velocity to go with it. 67 miles an hour. Almost 68. And she's ahead on the count here, a ball and two strikes. The pitch, just up. Really, it's, you know, for the Sooners through 18 now, this being their 19th game of the season. It's really only three innings in which they've struggled all year. That ball's bounced foul. They had the rough third against UCLA earlier this season, and rough early inning against Florida State as well, too. Coach Gasso told us on the pregame show the following day that it might have been a little bit much, given Sale the start.
Yeah.
Kind of made it tough, being back home, running a lot of hometown fans. 2-2 pitch, a little bit low. The Sooners fell behind in that game to Florida State 3-0, only to come back and tie it in the second inning. And then took the lead in the third. Florida State was too much as the 3-2 pitch is popped foul and out of play. Regardless, you take out maybe that second inning against Florida State, and then you fast forward that following weekend and went the third or fourth inning against UCLA. And really the only tough innings the Sooner pitching staff has had this year. And Sale throws it right by her. Strike three, two away. Back-to-back strikeouts by Shannon Sale. That's four straight strikeouts for Sooner pitchers. And Destiny, she threw that right by her.
Right by her. A little bit on the inside corner. But, I mean, right by her.
Two outs now for Skylar Schellmeyer. Shows bunt. Takes a pitch outside for ball one.
She's a little bit deceiving. She doesn't seem like she would be throwing 67 miles an hour to me. So it's got to be the release. I feel like her movement and her urgency through the mound isn't getting it there.
She's very smooth.
Yeah.
I think is a good way to put it, right? 1-0. That's in for a strike. There you see some of the attitude. A little smile back towards Grace Lyons at short. It'll be interesting to see what Coach Gasso and Coach Rocha decide to do with their pitching rotation the rest of this weekend. 1-1. Oh, my goodness. That was nasty. One ball, two strikes. Sale, the Land O'Lakes Florida product, has started four games this season, including the midweek game against McNeese, where she allowed just one hit and struck out seven. She has struck out now 47 in 26 innings so far this year. Swing and a miss. Strike three ends the inning. Shannon Sale comes in and brings the attitude and strikes out the side. Gotta love that. We head to the bottom of the sixth inning. Sooners in control, leading 7-0. Sooner softball presented by OG&E. Power at the speed of life on Sooner Sports TV. So it all Sooners, thanks to the fourth run explosion. A six-run fourth has opened the door for a 7-0 lead. Seven runs on seven hits, four home runs. Oklahoma has allowed just one hit, and Reagan Rogers will lead things off. Along with Destiny Martinez, I'm Chris Plank. The first pitch is low for a ball. Producer Theron Smith, director Michael Court. Joel Manning on site with us. Reagan Rogers, first at bat of the game. She's ahead on the count here at 2-0. I like Reagan's story because, Destiny, she had fought her way through the ranks to get on the depth chart.
Yeah, for sure. She's, I mean, to see her come this far and still getting her chances in the lineup.
It's this one fouled on the left field line.
It's awesome to see players like that because you know that they're fighting day in and day out at practice.
Numbers have been impressive so far on the season for Rogers, too. She's started 12 games. She's hitting 355 for the Bridge Creek product. Blanchard, Oklahoma, by way of Bridge Creek High School. Three home runs this season. 2-1. Hot shot right at the first baseman, Novak. And there's one away. Here's Mindy. Nicole Mendez has had a silently nice night considering the home run fest we've had. I'm sure Mendez's last at bat was a special one for you, Destiny, as the slapper yourself to see her place the ball where it needed to be. First pitch in for a strike.
Yeah, because you work so hard. I mean, for her especially, I wasn't a power hitter on top of being a slapper. I'm my main focus. Could have been, of course. No, but my main focus was to work the dirt, put pressure on the defense. And for her, I mean, she has to work so hard in so many different parts of her game that it's very interesting for me to see her excel and succeed in all aspects of it.
Well, one pitch is in the dirt, low. Though I think it's kind of Captain Obvious-ing things to say that if it's in the dirt, it's low. Run here can end it for the Sooners, or we can just take care of business with Shannon Sale striking out three more in the seventh. Regardless, it's been an impressive night for OU. 1-1 pitch misses, 2-1. Since Mendez has basically become the starting center fielder, she's now 5 for her last 12, has scored 5 runs with 2 home runs and 5 RBIs.
Not a bad stat.
Not bad at all. 3 of them. She is as athletic of a player as you'll find. She's won the triathlon 3 years in a row. I should say he's won it 2 the last 3 years. I don't believe she competed this year. Did she win it? Yeah, 3 in a row. There. That's impressive. 3-1, bounced. Yeah. Oh, nice play by Novak, who will take it to the bag. 2 away. First baseman getting some work in over at first.
Good play. Nice turn, too. Just go with the ball. Tag your base. Make it easy. Smooth.
And in Lindsey Elam's spot, it looks like we're going to see a pinch hitter, and it looks like it's going to be Sammy Skelly. So the freshman out of Lone Grove getting a little debrief here from Nicole Mendez. A couple of freshmen there. That's Audrey LaValle. Looks like she's moved into the on-deck circle, so if Skelly can get aboard, Audrey might get an at-bat here. There's a couple of Oklahoma products. Sammy against Louisiana here last Friday night hit her first career home run, and it was her first hit as a Sooner. Lost it over the right field wall. And she'll have an opportunity here to keep the bottom half of the sixth going for the Sooners with Oklahoma on top 7-0. Here's the first pitch. Bounces this one foul. Looked like maybe a little bit off of it for the Northwestern pitcher, Morgan Newport. 51 miles an hour. So 7 runs on 7 hits and 4 home runs. The 0-1. Skelly takes it up 1-1. So when do the butterflies stop during your freshman year when you get an at bat? Does it ever, or?
It depends. I think early in the season, it's a little bit worse. But as the season gets going and you start understanding your teammates, understanding your coaches, understanding all the plays, I think my big issue was when I started, we didn't have those cards.
Oh, I got you.
So
you had to memorize
Gasso
it?
Was trying to give me signs. Yeah. So that was tough because as a slapper, you have bunt, you have soft slap, you have heart power slap, you have chop, you have all these things, and she's like sliding one hand down her leg, one hand on her, like, that was the hardest, most stressful part of my freshman year.
Ground ball to short. Skelly's thrown out at first, and that ends things for the Sooners in the sixth. Sooners 3 outs away from a win. As we head to the seventh, Oklahoma in control, leading Northwestern 7-0. Oklahoma leads at 7-0. No yawning! No yawning! There you go. Sooners on top 7 to zip. 4 home runs tonight, including a bomb that left here from Shea Knight. Grace Green is now out in right field. So Grace will move to the outfield. She was an outfielder, third baseman whenever she came in. Grace gets some time in right, which means Aaliyah Flores has checked in over at first as the first pitch is grounded to third. Sid makes everything look easy, and she throws to Flores, who makes the play, and there's one away. So there's Aaliyah, the new first baseman for the Sooners. Love the new eye black look in 2019 for the Cali product. And at second base is Audrey LaValle, who was on deck whenever Sammy Skelly grounded out. LaValle's got a chance to be in that battle for the everyday second base job next year for the Choctaw product. One away here in the seventh inning. Here's Nelson. First pitch to Maeve Nelson is on the inside corner for a strike, and all that Shannon Sale has done, Destiny Martinez, since she's come in, is throw strikes. Oh, behind the plate, too. Kinsey Kelso has just checked in, too. I mean, not just, but she's been in to start this inning. The 0-1 has popped up and a stay foul. Kelso's a pretty incredible story for the Sooners. She decided to enroll early at the spring semester, and Kinsey actually started the midweek game against McNeese. Got her first collegiate hit in the win over Cal State Fullerton out of the Mary Nutter Classic. Started that game against Cal Santa Barbara and started the game against McNeese. The 0-2. Smith is outside. The one thing you'll notice about Kelso is how smooth she is behind the plate. But as a freshman, obviously it's going to take some time. She's pushing for playing time, though, and it gives Coach Gasso and Coach Rocha a very young and exciting backup to Lindsay Elam, who allows her to get some rest. 1-2 pitch. Swing, a miss. Strike 3, sail through and right by her.
And it's always good to get experience in games like this.
Sooners are 1 out away from picking up a win. Look at Shannon Sale throwing it right by.
She's really getting all of these hitters on rise balls.
Sooners looking for their 7th win in a row. That was just nasty. Strike 1. Cochran swung through it. watch this again.
A little bit off balance.
Maybe fooled Kelso, who takes one off the shin guard on the foul tip for strike two. Now the Sooners are one strike away. And for some reason, Kate Drohan wants to have a quick conversation here. Slow this thing down just a bit. See if we can't start a rally. Sooners on top 7-0. Here in the seventh. Seven runs on seven hits. Well, he was only allowed one hit. Sooners won their midweek game over McNeese 6-1. Missing outside. NorthWestern had to survive against Drake in extra innings. Doesn't look like they're going to be able to survive here. 1-2 pitches high, 2-2. Though there is an incredible number from last year. They won five games in 2018. When they entered the seventh inning trailing by two or more runs. This would be pretty epic.
And they came back and won those?
Yeah, 2-2. Wow. Doesn't matter here. Swing and a miss. Win column Sooners. Seven in a row. 38 straight at home. And Oklahoma rolls over NorthWestern by a final score of 7-0. The postgame show is coming up next. This is Sooner Softball presented by OG&E. Power the speed of life. Oklahoma wins it tonight by a final score of 7-0, thanks to four home runs and a dominant performance from G. Juarez in the circle with some help from Shannon Sale along with Destiny Martinez. I'm Chris Plank. It's the Bud Light postgame show. And how impressed were you tonight with all aspects of this game, Destiny?
I was really impressed with Giselle. She's able to mix speeds, keep the hitters off balance. Her rise ball is awesome. But even the hitters, they were impressive tonight.
Yeah, the hitters, you mentioned how impressive they were. We'll brag on them coming up here in just a bit. But G. Juarez was doing a little bit of everything. And you talked about it a lot. You liked the way that she moved the ball around in the game that Jen Rocha called, but also changing speeds a lot tonight.
Right. When you can change speeds, you can keep the batters way off balance, and that's going to be very successful for a rise ball, for all of your other pitchers to really work out for you.
Impressive all night long. She had the NorthWestern hitters off balance all night long. Well, the third inning is where the Sooner bats woke up, thanks to Grace Lyons. I mean, wow, a shot over the batter's eye in center field. And then the fourth, well, the seniors took over. Sid Romero. And then Shay Knighton decides, wait, you can't have all the fun. She hits one deep into the night. And then after a couple of base runners, Kylie Lundberg says, let's make this a senior party. And she takes one out as Oklahoma absolutely takes control with that six-run fourth inning. And then Shannon Sale. Impressed with Shannon Sale?
I am impressed with Shannon Sale. She's throwing gas up there, and she's also able to keep the hitters off balance. But one thing I noticed is she could really work the corners and get them to chase up and down. So she was very successful, and I'm really impressed with her as well.
Let's take a look at the Taco Mayo final stats as Shannon Sale helped seal the deal for the Sooners in the win. There you go. Juarez, five innings, striking out six. Three more K's for Shannon Sale. So the Sooner actually was four more. So 10 strikeouts tonight by the Sooner pitchers. And there's another multiple hit game for Grace Lyons. And a big night for Sid Romero. Seven straight wins now for the Sooners. They improved to 17-2 on the season. And they've now won 38 straight games at home. It was a party at Marita Hines Field. And it was yet another Sooner win. For my partner, Destiny Martinez, for Theron Smith and our crew here at Sooner Sports TV, I'm Chris Plank, signing off for Marita Hines Field, where the Sooners win. And until next time, Boomer Sooner, everybody.